Hey guys, Chaney here. I wanted to hop on and talk about some collective downloads I'm getting for the Libra new moon. Happy Libra new moon. Happy Libra season. Happy birthday, Libras. This is a season of karma, justice, balance. Also bringing in manifestations. This is heavy energy that's coming through. Also, I've been getting... Oh, by the way, so I'm going to talk about intuitive downloads I've been getting for the collective, and then we'll pull some cards. So I've been seeing a lot of salamanders, and today, somehow one got into my house. Don't know how he got in. I saw him in the kitchen. He was, like, flopping around. He freaked out when he saw me. I was like, oh, snap, buddy, you okay? And he, like, crawled under my fridge. And I've been trying to, like, explain that if he comes out, I'll... help the salamander out of my house, otherwise my cat's gonna use it as a play toy. So hopefully we work that situation out. Hopefully we can come to an understanding. But anyways, the salamander imagery that I wanted to talk about is, like, there's a lot of different symbology for it. What I'm getting strongly for the collective is that renewal, rebirth, the ability to grow, like, they can regrow their limbs or their tails. So, but they're also heavily associated with surviving fire, like being, so yeah, like a strong symbolism of survival. What else was it for that? So I was also getting for you guys, because the last Libra reading I did had the main theme was time, and how it's viewed, how you can manipulate it, or how you see it, perceive it. But I also saw there was something about, like, there was a question in my YouTube feed about what if the matrix no longer existed. Okay, let me back up. Imagination is not a gift. It's something to be conquered. So those of us with, like, strong imagination know that it's something to be conquered. Like, because it can't get the better of you. So I feel like that's a strong theme going on right now, in terms of, like, how we're imagining our new world, but also something to do with time and time hopping, portals. I feel like that's also strong energy going on right now. Is there anything else I wanted to talk about? I don't think so. We can pull some cards. I want to do an elemental read. So we have the modern witch's tarot. We're going to start with air energy, so it's going to be your mental energy. So we'll see where the collective's mental air energy is at right now. The Fool. Yes. Taking a leap. Something new. I like that. Oh my gosh. Another thing about the salamander I wanted to talk about. Okay, because they also, like, represent things that are hidden. And I feel like there might be something that you could be getting, like, hints about, but you're not getting the full story just yet. I feel like there's something, like, you know you're going to, like, something is going to be revealed. Like, you know that it just hasn't been revealed yet, but it will be. But I feel like there's something that needs to, like, be done, or temperance is required first. I'm not sure. I feel like it's different for everybody. So anyways, mental energy is focused on, like, taking a leap, time hopping, doing something completely new, changing it up, and, like, so let's check in on our fiery collective energy. So that's gonna be what we're passionate about. So what's the collective passionate about right now? Okay, this one's, like, sideways, so I'm gonna take it. Seven of Swords. Shit. I'm gonna get another one. What is the collective passion about right now? Swords, and we have the Queen of Cups. Okay. Strategy. So the Knight of Swords. Fudge. Ambitious, action-oriented, driven to succeed, fast-thinking. What you're passionate about is what you're passionate about. Something that you want to move towards. Also with the Queen of Cups, that's like emotional energy. Something that like actually like emotionally fulfills you, makes you want to like wake up in the morning, is what your, as far as like you taking this leap, that's what you want to take a leap towards. Feeling like emotionally fulfilled and like driven every day when you wake up. Not to say that you don't, but I feel like there might be something that like feels like a little lackluster, but I feel like you're acting strategically to take the steps. And I know that sometimes the Seven of Swords can be like a negative card, but I'm really not getting that right now. I'm getting like you're leaving the past in the past and taking the lessons you learned and using them to your advantage so that you can continue to or start feeling like driven and successful and like emotionally fulfilled every day. Cool. I like that. Okay. Let's see, as far as your grounded earthly energy, let's see what's grounding the collective right now. Okay, two. Ooh, ooh, ooh. So sorry. I'm so sorry. I got so excited. It's the Emperor in the world. So, Emperor energy on your throne. Also, the world. It's like another card of like time manipulation. I keep saying manipulation. Like, it's not in a negative sense. It's. So, you know how like you can like shift things out of your energy to bring in new things? That's what I'm trying to say when I say that. I just want to reiterate that. So as far as the Emperor being on your throne, I feel like you're ready to take a leap because you know you want to be happy about what you do every day and what you spend your time doing. And by you like feeling being in that position, you're sitting on your throne, you're manifesting exactly what you want. You're making that world into a reality, and that's what's grounding you right now, is knowing what you want and focusing on that so that you bring it in. Even if you don't know exactly what you want, knowing that you, if it's something else, gets you somewhere. Like it brings in or takes out, like the universe will remove things to replace them with things that work out more to your benefit. I'm getting like that's happening for a lot of the collective right now. Yeah, I've seen 10 of Wands at the bottom of the deck. So like you could have felt like overburdened or worried, but I feel like things are shifting to your advantage now because you're taking more, less of a laid back view, taking more of a on your throne type of stance, you know. Let's check out the collective's emotional energy. So your cups, your water. Oh, snippity. Are we the star? That's hope, spirituality, renewal, faith. So you're emotionally hopeful. Yeah, okay. Also the two of cups in reverse. Is that self-love? Yeah, self-love. I really like that. I feel like mostly for the collective, like where you're coming from, or at least like, yeah, I feel like where you're coming from is from a place of self-love and hope. And if you continue to stay in awareness of approaching life from that stance, I feel like you're going to be successful. Like, being honest with yourself. Yeah, and then we have Three of Wands at the bottom of the deck. So it's new beginnings. I do want to clarify my little handmade deck for mental energy, the Fool. Okay, those said they get 360s, two of them. Should we look? Okay, we have Rainbow and Solar Plexus Chakra. So, I mean, this whole Fool card is yellow, so Solar Plexus Chakra. I also just saw the Cancer card. If you have prominent Cancer placements, you need to work on your Solar Plexus Chakra. Oh, yeah. I just wanted to bring up. I was getting a lot of, like, gold and yellow energy. So, it could be that work needs to be done on, like, your solar, like, your lower chakras, your root, your sacral, and your solar plexus. It could be really helpful and beneficial at this time. And then Rainbow, yeah, that just reminds me of the chakras. So that's why I brought up the others. I feel like a lot of focus inward, yeah, like self-love, focusing inward on yourself. It's going to be super helpful and super beneficial during this time. Let's go ahead and clarify what's the grounding energy with the World and the Emperor. YouTube channel. Maybe you want to start a YouTube channel. Let's see what else. I'm going to get another one. Billionaire. Okay. That's awesome. Just the beginning. At the bottom of the deck. Holy snap. That's a heavy message. Okay. I don't know who that applies for. I don't. If you've been thinking about it and you feel like that part's your message, remember this is a collective reading, guys. But yeah, I feel like that's your message. Obviously, you know what to do. Let's go ahead and clarify the passionate energy, which we got three cards. We talked about acting strategically in terms of making sure that you're focused and working toward the things that make you feel successful and emotionally fulfilled, so like you're happy to wake up every day. Let's clarify that. Rest and renewal. Yes, we're just talking about that. Spending some time, like self-love, focusing on yourself. Getting another one. Earth Star Chakra. It's like a heavy grounding card. So the Earth Star Chakra is located below. It's debatable like how low below your feet into the ground. But because we also have the Soul Star Chakra, which is located above our crown chakra, and then we have the Earth Star Chakra. So that keeps us grounded. It grounds us to this planet we're currently vibing on. And as far as like that matrix thing I was bringing up, maybe the acceptance of, maybe you're having like this weird come to moment of acceptance that you're on Earth right now and you just gotta make the best of it. And I feel like that's really helping you. Yeah. I'm going to get one more card, though. Because we've got three of those. So, throat chakra. Okay. Also, I'm seeing fast. Okay. I thought it was one more. We have throat chakra and sacral chakra. Yes. Okay. So, throat chakra is being honest with yourself. Like we were talking about before, being honest with yourself about like what genuinely makes you happy to do what you do every day. What keeps you smiling? What's got you smiling like that? But yeah, something about fast. Yeah, with the Knight of Swords, it's a fast moving card. Maybe you're fastly coming into realization about like what truly matters to you, what truly makes you feel secure and grounded in this existence. What makes it worth it? call you back. I'll call you back. Hold on. Okay. Let's clarify the last cards. For watery emotional energy. Okay, that was a whole stack. We're going to put them back. If they're meant to come out, they will. So we have the Star, and then we have the Two of Cups in reverse, which is self-love, and the Star is like hope, faith, renewal, spirituality, so it's clarify growth, ever-expanding. Growth. Yeah, so maybe your faith and hope is expanding. You've got the B. So focusing on the good, the sweet stuff, the honey, the nectar. I think I'm going to leave it at that. We're gonna leave it at that. Alright, cool. Happy Libra New Moon. Take it easy, collective. Boy!